Look ahead for reference points. At 60 miles an hour, you're traveling at 88 feet per second. At 120 miles per hour, you're hurtling through space at 176 feet per second. That second ticks by very quickly. And if you're not ready for the next move ahead of time, you'll make a mistake. Looking ahead for your reference points and subproducts gives you time to prepare for the next move so there are no surprises and so everything goes smoothly. This idea can be taken too far, however. I've seen riders looking 150 feet down the road while rounding a tight 40 mile per hour curve. They were ignoring what was to be seen in front of them, like curbing and holes. Still other riders in the same turn were looking at the curbing and holes, but not until they were just 20 feet in front of them. Both of these extremes are unworkable. They produce uncertain riding through the turn and slow cornering. Where to look? Two factors will help you determine where to look while you're riding or racing. One, at speed, the further ahead you look, the slower you believe you're going. The closer to yourself you look, the faster you believe you're going. Look far enough ahead to avoid accelerating the scene, but not so far that you lose your feel for where you are on the track. With RPs, you have a choice of where to look. Two, having enough RPs has the effect of opening up the track, making it appear larger. When you look too far ahead or too close to the bike, the track seems to narrow. If this begins happening, it is your signal to either change reference points or to find more of them in that turn or section of track. These are guidelines. Adjust the reference points so the scene is moving at the right speed for you and so you can see enough to keep the track opened up. Having only one reference point is like having only one car. If it breaks or doesn't work, you don't go anywhere. If you have another, you can easily use the one that works. With only one reference point or car, it becomes too valuable and necessary. If you find that your attention is fixed on one point on the track or road, it's because you don't have another ready to use. That one becomes very valuable to you, and you overuse it. You depend upon it for too much information and might begin staring at it. You can become slightly lost when it no longer lets you know where you are or what to do. If you find your attention becoming fixed on one reference point, you need to find another in the area so the movie will smooth out. Stepping stones. Reference points are your stepping stones to the products and subproducts you will produce in a turn or series of turns. These little steps lead to the major changes you will make to get the bike around turns faster or with more confidence. RPs signal the points on the track where you will make these changes. Eddie noted, "It's important to pick up good reference points, especially on the exit." Concentration. On the track or road, concentration is a smooth flow or chain of events that moves from one to another without a break. Reference points are part of that chain, one link depending upon the next for strength and a continuous flow. If one link breaks, the entire chain stays broken until it can be repaired or replaced. If you have a section of the track with no or too few reference points, your chain of concentration will break. Reference points are the building blocks of concentration. Let's get back to the idea of your attention and how much of it you have, your $10 bill. When your concentration is good, you spend just enough of it on each RP so that you know where you are and what to do. This keeps that steady flow going. When you have too few reference points in an area, most of your attention will be spent in trying to fix this bad situation. The points or places on the track that you do not know or understand will occupy most of your attention. Having enough reference points lets you spend just the right amount of time and attention on each one to get the information you need. You have enough left over to buy other things, to make small changes in your riding that will help you go just a bit faster or lean over just a bit more. Everything you do on the track takes up some attention. When you don't have enough reference points, your attention goes right to that area and will, or can, break your concentration. Some of the strangest things happen when you have a break in your concentration. One rider told me that every time his concentration breaks, he begins thinking of a leaking faucet he has at home. Your mind may not wander to a leaking faucet, but when your concentration breaks, you will notice that other things come into your mind. Concentration, the twist. There's a twist to this subject of concentration. When you've got it, it doesn't seem to you you're looking at anything in particular. The reference points just blend into the scene in front of you. When asked, "What do you look at in turns?" two or three of the top riders in the world have said, "I don't really look at anything." But is this really what they mean? When your concentration is good, you spend just nickels and dimes on the reference points and none of them captures your attention. An example of this is that one major difference between riders is their ability to learn tracks. Learning tracks means knowing where you are on the track. Some riders can do it in 5 laps, others can't do it in 500 laps. Both guys have to learn where they are by reference points. The top riders just do it so fast they can beat you on your favorite road the second time you take them there. One factor that separates the top riders from the rest of the field is that they pick up reference points quickly and accurately to the point they can see the whole scene without having to pick out the individual reference points. Here's Eddie's take on it. I like to go to new tracks. It's fun. The first year I raced, we went to the tracks that everybody raced, and I just did okay. At the new tracks, though, I was right there, first or second.